Hello everybody, mega goal number one for secondary 10 writing pages 42 and 43. Now let's take a look at the objectives. باختصار الهدف, we should be able to write a story. راح نكتب قصة من طبعا نكتب قصة بشكل عام, and as well we are gonna discuss the elements of the story, يعني شنو مكونات أو عناصر القصة. Now let's take a look. This unit is called What Will Be Will Be. So turn writing. So please move on to pages 42 and 43. Now as usual, طبعا كالعادة عندنا a model اللي هو نموذج, ومن خلال هذا النموذج راح نناقش how to write a story, كيف نكتب قصة. Now take a look at the story. طبعا we are not gonna read it, we are just gonna go through the questions, and then of course you are يعني you are free to read the story يعني by yourself. انتوا يعني حرين انكم تقرؤون القصة بأنفسكم. Now we have to answer the questions. Read the title. Who do you think the keeper is? من تعتقدون الكيبر is? Now look at the photos. We have here photo. Where was the treasure hidden? طبعا بنتكلم اليوم اللي هو عن الكنز. So here we have photos, and we are asked to locate the treasure. Where do you think it's hidden? وين تعتقدون انه هو مخبأ? So from the picture we guess that the treasure اللي هو الكنز is hidden in the ocean or in the sea, في البحر أو في المحيط. Now the title of the story, عنوان القصة, keeper of hidden treasure, اللي هو مثلا محافظ أو على الكنز المفقود. Now let's take a look at the question here. You are asked to read the story and make notes in the box. طيب مطلوب مننا نترك طبعا نعبي البوكس بالنوت أو الملاحظات. Anyways, who found the treasure? مين اللي يعني وجد الكنز? So a Korean fisherman, يعني صياد كوري. Now where, so who, we are here. لازم تعرف ان لما نسأل عنه معناته نبغى نعرف شخص. And so a Korean fisherman, where did he find it? Where did he find it? Off or near the Korean shore, بالقرب من الشاطئ الكوري. طبعا where معناها location, مكان. How did he find it? نسأل عن الكيفية. So I've highlighted the answer here because we do not have enough room here. ما في مسافة كافية أو مكان فاضي. So he caught an octopus that has bites of blue pottery attracted to his to its tentacles, and he caught more octopus, and they all had shards attached to their tentacles. Okay, so طبعا شافها في اللي هو في عند يعني الأخطبوط, وانتو عارفين الأخطبوط they have as we see here tentacles. Okay, so this is how he found the hidden treasure. And what was the hidden treasure? إيش الكنز المفقود? 30 perfect 12th century bull, يعني عبارة عن أوعية من 30 وعاء من القرن الثاني عشر. Now what, طبعا what, ماذا, again, so let's here highlight the question word. So it's very important because this is will guide you to the answer to the question. يعني لما نعرف the question word نعرف إيش اللي راح نبحث عن. Now what did he do with it? What did he do? طبعا it يقصدون فيها the hidden treasure. He reported it to the museum, يعني بلغ أو he contacted the museum اللي هو المتحف. Okay, so this is mainly the story that you are طبعا you should probably read by yourself, keeper of hidden treasure. So this is mainly is a story. Right now let's move on to the next page and discuss the elements of the story. And of course طبعا مطلوب منا ان احنا think about a story about hidden treasure, عن كنز مخبأ that you have read or heard. ممكن تكون قرأت أو ممكن تكون سمعت عنه. Now you are asked to make notes in the chart below and then use your note to write the story. طبعا هنا مثل graphic organizer اللي هي مثل الخرائط المعرفية أو concept map ممكن تساعدنا في كتابة القصة. So here, why did he hide it? لماذا؟ Why? What is the reason? السبب. Okay. Why? Who? The person. طبعا who did it? من الذي فعل هذا يعني the treasure؟ من اللي خبأه؟ Where was it hidden? Here we are asking about the place. Okay. What was the treasure? ماذا هو ما هو الكنز؟ Okay. So what? And who found it? من الذي وجده؟ So who did it? من الذي خبأه؟ And who found it? من الذي أوجده؟ How did he find it? كيف وجده؟ And what did he do with it? ما الذي فعل به؟ طبعا شوفوا كيف الأسهم. Follow them as you fill this chart. طبعا why, who, where, and then who did it. طبعا and then طبعا how did he find it and what did he do with it. Okay, so right now you are gonna, so this is the topic. You are gonna write or think right now about the story about, or a story about a hidden treasure. Now let's discuss the element of this story اللي هي المكونات أو عناصر القصة. This is very important. Please to pay attention as I explain this. So mainly when we write a story, there are a couple of things, بعض الأشياء that we need to concentrate on. لازم نركز عليهم. Okay, so we are gonna think about the audience اللي هما الجمهور أو who is it written for, and the people in the story or the characters اللي هما الشخصيات, the place or places or as well the time اللي نسميها الوقت أو الزمن وكذلك المكان نسميها setting, the events اللي هي الأحداث or the plot, the time اللي هو الوقت, order of the events اللي هي يعني هل هي تكون بالترتيب أو مو مهم, and also we have to think about the beginning and the end of the story. So let's start with the audience. نبدأ بالجمهور. So mainly when you are writing a story, you have to think who is reading or listening to the story. مهم جدا ان طبعا ان احنا نفكر في مين اللي راح يسمع او يقرا القصه. طبعا okay, if I ask you for example, maybe you have heard or you have read a story, ممكن سمعته او قراته قصه. Think why يعني you liked these stories. لماذا حببت هذا القصص؟ Think about the reason. وبناء على هذه الأسباب ممكن تفكر ليش الناس ممكن تحب القصة. Okay, so this is a very important thing that you think about the audience and who will be reading or listening to your story. Then later on, of course, you have to think about the characters or the people in your story. This is the character actually, or the characters are extremely important in stories. مهمين جدا في القصة. Okay, so the whole story or the whole stories usually are mainly based on the characters. يعني مبنية كثير على الشخصيات. طبعا مهم جدا. طبعا when you are يعني introducing your character, لما تقدم مثلا شخصياتك, you have to think about these characters very carefully. ممكن لازم تفكر بهذه الشخصيات بجدا بعناية. For example, you can give them names. ممكن تعطيهم أسماء, بس you have to choose these names very carefully. Okay. طبعا برضو مو بس نتكلم عن الشخصيات من فقط إعطائهم الأسماء. Also try to picture them in their minds. حاول تخليهم يتخيلونهم في عقلهم. Okay. طبعا this is very important as well. As well, طبعا don't only think, مو تفكر بس about how to, the audience will picture these characters in their minds or about يعني giving them names. Also think about their personality اللي هما شخصيات. Are they good people or bad people? Anyways, now let's move on to the next part, which is the place. The place is very important as well. المكان جدا مهم. Okay, it's not enough to simply name a place. يعني مو فقط نعطي اسم المكان. Also think about The place, طبعاً, is it located? Is it a home? Is it gonna be at work? Okay, and what kind of home is it? ما نوع المنزل? Is it large or small? Where is it located? أين يقع? Is it traditional? Are they do they have large windows? This is very important. يعني مو فقط لما أروي القصة أذكر إن أقول مثلاً حدثت في منزل. لا, يعني حاول تعطي بعد وصف أكثر. Okay, and later on, of course, you have to think about as well the event, اللي هما الأحداث. What happened in your story? Use past verb forms. طبعا هنا plot or events اللي هي الأحداث أو الحبكة. This is also a very important part of the story. And this is something that most of the audience or most of the people pay attention to. Okay, and طبعا you have to think about what happened in your story. ما الذي حصل في قصتك, okay؟ طبعا وهنا مكتوب ان احنا نستخدم الفعل الماضي. طبعا اكيد اذا احنا نتكلم عن الماضي مهم جدا ان احنا يعني نتكلم عن قصة حصلت في الماضي نستخدم الـ past verb forms اللي هي الفعل الماضي بأشكاله يعني جميعها, okay؟ Now, as well, it's very important to think about the time. طبعاً, the time or the place, نسميها setting altogether. عموماً, the time, things happen. متى حصل الأشياء? Which year is your story set in? What time of day is it? Which season is it? Use the past time. طبعاً, time is also a very important element in your story. And when we often tell a story, طبعاً, لما نقول مثلاً قصة, مهم جدا ان احنا نذكر مثلا الوقت اللي حصلت فيه الزمن. طبعا عادة بتكون في الماضي. طبعا بنتكلم عن وقت مثلا في اليوم, مثلا كانت في at night or in the evening. طبعا اذا كانت في الوينتر او مثلا كانت في السمر تايم. This is very important. طبعا let's move on to the next one. الجزء اللي بعده which is the order of the event. طبعاً the order of the event is طبعاً they do not have to be the orders. The events they do not have to be an order. يعني مو ضروري إنهم يكونون بالترتيب. Sometimes you start from the end but then you go back وهكذا. So it's not that important. But it's very as well to think about, يعني مهم جدا نحن نفكر what happened first, second, third, and so on. طبعا here you are asked to use a variety of past tenses to order your event. طبعا ممكن نستخدم أنواع مختلفة من الفعل الماضي. So يعني لازم نفكر فيها بس مش ضروري تكون بالترتيب. The last thing we should as well discuss is the beginning and the ending. طبعا مهم جدا ان احنا نفكر في النهاية, عفوا beginning البداية ونهاية القصة. It's very important to think about how you are going to begin and end even if you decide to make changes later. مهم جدا ان الواحد يفكر في البداية والنهاية عشان يفكر شنو راح يحصل, يعني ممكن إذا حاب يغير شيء. How will you begin your story? How will you end your story? طبعا مثل ما قلت لكم أحيانا الواحد يبدأ من النهاية وبعدين يبدأ يعني مثلا يرجع للبداية, فمو مهم جدا بس لازم يكون طبعا مترابطة. Okay. Now here طبعا we are gonna right now discuss couple of things right now very quickly. Now, what do you think causes a reaction? يعني شو اللي تعتقدون اللي يخلي ناس مثلاً يعني reacted, يعني يكون ردة فعل مثلاً شو اللي يخلي الناس مثلاً to be surprised, يعني تتفاجأ, يعني to be interesting, تكون يعني متشوقة. For example, to laugh, أنها تضحك. يعني فكروا مثلا في a movie أو مثلا a story that you have read, أنكم قرأتوها. ليش تعتقدون أنها خلتكم أضحكتكم؟ ليش تعتقدون أنها أثارتكم؟ يعني بمعنى أنها كانت مشوقة. ليش تعتقدون أنها فاجأتكم القصة؟ طيب هل تعتقدون ان مثلا ان الكاتب او مثلا اللي سوى الفيلم الفيلم ميكر اعطاكم المعلومات كلها مره واحده ولا جرادولي بالترتيب؟ انتو كنتو تعرفين شو اللي راح يصير بعدها، ولا كان في مثلا كلوز اشياء دلتكم على هالشيء؟ مهم جدا ان نفكر في هذه الاشياء، وطبعا we reflect on them، يعني معناها نتأملهم بعدين نشوف شو اللي يخلي الشيء مثلا مثير ومشوق ومثلا تخليك متفاجئ. Now وبرضو فكروا how did that make you feel، كيف خلاكم تشعرون. Now what was your reaction to the octopus story؟ طبعا ممكن تقولوا لي شنو كان إذا after طبعا reading شنو كان ردة فعلكم تجاه قصة اللي هو الأخطبوط. So right now we have discussed the elements of the story, and we discussed what is asked from you, which is to write a story about a hidden treasure that you have heard or heard or طبعا you have read or heard or you have يعني imagined أو تخيلتها. Anyways, I hope that you have liked our lesson. Don't forget to subscribe, share this video with your friends, and leave me a thumb up. Until next time, have a good one.